Let's first get you all the updates from the state of Maharashtra. Congress leader Sanjay Nirupam declared on Thursday that he would not campaign in the upcoming Maharashtra election. The former MP also said the way the party's leadership was behaving with him, the time to say goodbye to the party was not far away. The three-time MP's rebellion hits the party at a time when many of its leaders in the state have crossed over to the ruling BJP-Shiv Sena combined. He is reportedly upset that the party rejected a candidate that he had suggested.
पहले तो तीन लिस्ट निकल गई, तो मैं सुबह आज मैंने खड़गे जी को बताया कि तीन लिस्ट निकल गई, मेरी इतनी भी इज्जत नहीं है। और आज पता चला चार बजे तक कि वहाँ पे जो नाम मैंने दिया था उसको रिजेक्ट कर रहे हैं लोग। तब मैंने कहा इसका मतलब पार्टी को मेरी सेवाओं की आवश्यकता नहीं है, और पार्टी को मेरी सेवाओं की आवश्यकता नहीं है तो बेहतर है मैं पूरे कैंपेन से, चुनाव प्रचार से अपने आप को वापस ले लूँ और चुनाव प्रचार में हिस्सा न लूँ। बस इतना ही मेरा, इतनी मेरी घोषणा है।
Maharashtra has played a crucial role in strengthening the economy of the country ever since independence. Currently, the state has the largest economy in the country in terms of GDP, but it still battles the scourge of drought and unemployment. The government is taking several measures to mitigate the crisis, but a lot more needs to be done. Here's a ground report from Maharashtra.
Mumbai, the financial capital of India, houses the headquarters of all major banks, financial institutions and industries. India's largest and Asia's oldest stock exchange, the Bombay Stock Exchange, is also in Mumbai. The port city has played a key role in India's trade for centuries, with Mumbai driving the growth of the industrial state of Maharashtra. The growth of Maharashtra saw a major boom in the post-liberalization era. Today, the state has the largest economy in India according to the GDP figures.
जो ease of doing business में जो भी भारत सरकार को एक बड़ी छलांग लगाई, मैं कह सकता हूँ कि उसमें जो improvement होते होते अभी top 100 में 76 नंबर जो आ गया government का, तो उसमें महाराष्ट्र का बहुत बड़ा सहयोग हुआ है.
In the past 5 years, while the Indian economy expanded at an average annual rate of 7.5%, Maharashtra grew at 7.6%. Per capita income has also seen a steady growth in the state in the past few years. Metro and several other infrastructure projects are underway in the state, boosting its economy further.
7 metro ke projects hai aur additionally aap dekhoge to metro ke alawa bhi Mumbai se Ahmedabad bullet train hone wali hai. मुंबई गोवा का एक बड़ा काम चल रहा है, साइड बाय साइड मुंबई बैंगलोर ये जो रास्ता है वो 4 लेन का हो गया, तो इस तरह से जो कनेक्ट होना चाहिए उसका काम बड़े पैमाने पे चल रहा है.
Repeated droughts in the past years have negatively impacted the economy of the state. Many areas in western Maharashtra, such as eastern Pune district, Solapur, Sangli, Satara, Ahmednagar and the Marathwada region, are particularly prone to drought. The state government has taken several measures for drought relief, including irrigation facilities and action plans for dealing with water scarcity. A lot also needs to be done to provide employment opportunities to the youth of the state. Navikram Singh's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And let's now take a look at some news and updates from another election poll-bound state of Haryana. A day after protesting outside Congress President Sonia Gandhi's residence in Delhi over alleged irregularities in ticket distribution, former Haryana Congress chief Ashok Tawar has resigned from all election committees of the party. However, he said he would continue to work as an ordinary party worker. In his letter to interim party president Sonia Gandhi, Tawar alleged that the party in Haryana had turned into Huda Congress, saying those who worked against the party's interests in the last 5 years have been given prominence over those who who slogged to strengthen the opposition party in the state. He further claimed that he was voicing the aspirations of millions of staunch Congress supporters, voters and local leaders. Tawar highlighted that as the outgoing PCC president, he had suggested a just and objective criteria for selection of candidates, but that was not being followed. Haryana may be a small state in terms of area and population, but it makes important contributions in the economy of the country, whether in the field of agriculture or industry. Haryana has carved a distinct identity in all important sectors. My colleague Ravindra Shoran reports from Haryana.
Situated adjacent to national capital Delhi, Haryana is a mainly agrarian economy, but has also continuously developed its industries. And those efforts have borne fruit, with Gurugram, Faridabad and Sonipat being prime examples.
दो चीजों में 1966 से अब तक बहुत बढ़िया प्रोग्रेस हुई है. एक तो एजुकेशन में जो सबसे ज्यादा हुई है और दूसरी इंडस्ट्रीज में हुई. हालांकि इंडस्ट्रीज में पिछले 2-3 साल से कुछ गिरावट दिख रही है क्योंकि लोग तो कहते हैं भाई इंटरनेशनल एस्पेक्ट हैं सारे.
Manufacturing plants of Maruti Suzuki, Hero Honda and MMT give Haryana an identity that is distinct from agriculture. Apart from this, Gurugram is known for its tech firms. This shows that Haryana has kept pace with other states in terms of industrial development.
भौगोलिक दृष्टि से भी अगर आप देखें तो क्योंकि दिल्ली के तीन तरफ हरियाणा पड़ता है और एनसीआर रीजन में भी हरियाणा के आधे जिले तो वैसे ही आ जाते हैं, तो हर क्षेत्र में विकास हुआ है. उस लिहाज से अगर देखें तो जो यात्रा रही है हरियाणा की अब तक की इसके गठन के बाद से वो शानदार रही है.
इन द लास्ट फ्यू ईयर्स इंडस्ट्रीज हैव बीन प्रमोटेड इन हरियाणा थ्रू फॉरेन इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड SEZs. In view of the growing urbanization in the tri-cities of Panchkula, Mohali and Chandigarh, there is an increased focus on creating institutional infrastructure as well. And the state government's efforts have propelled Haryana to first place in North India and third place in all of India in the ease of doing business rankings. Ravindra Singh Shoran's report for Rajya Sabha TV.